on your feet and make some noise for one of the most phenomenal female groups of our time.
I didn't hear that.
Jackie. Linda. Harold. Quickie. The clock does not.
Sunday, January the 31st, 2021, in Holly Hill, South Carolina, where our pastor is the Reverend Malcom O. Simpson.
Let us give the Lord some praise. Right where you are in your living room, in the kitchen, or wherever you're watching this live stream, let's clap our hands and give the Lord some praise. He has blessed us to be yet alive on the very last day of January 2021. Therefore, we give honor to our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. He is indeed the head of all of our lives. To this wonderful ministerial staff, right here at Mount Olive Amy Church, to the Linda Sumter, to the Reverend Eloise Hart, to Brother Robert Miles, licentiate here at Mount Olive Amy Church, to our sensational and dynamic, amen, our local WMS president, Sister Bernice Howell, who is going to bring the word this morning. Yes, she is. Let's give the Lord some praise. Our WMS president is going to bring the word this morning. And to my queen, to my earth angel, to my heavenly sweet dove, amen. The prettiest first lady in all African Methodism, Sister Lashele Yvette Simpson. We give the Lord praise. Amen. These are your announcements this morning. And I'm going to try to be very expeditious this morning because I'm excited about what the Lord has in store for us for this wonderful worship experience. On Wednesday night church school is every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. weekly. And we want you all to continue to join us for our Wednesday night church school. We're having sensational studies on Wednesday evening. We want you to experience what God is teaching us through his word. So the conference call number is 978-990-5054. And the access code is 321-1559. Join us for our Wednesday night church school. A friendly reminder that we will be giving out communion sets every single first Saturday, amen, from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Come and receive your communion sets. Hold your communion sets to Sunday morning so that we can feast on the body and the blood of Christ. Amen. After worship service right here at Mount Olivet Church. I want to thank every one of you that came out to Mount Olivet Church on this past Thursday for our free drive-through COVID-19 testing. For what I understand, we had a large turnout. Amen. And we give God praise for that. Mount Olivet Church wants to do their part to offer services to the community to make sure that those who are living in this community get the testing that is needed to make sure that you are COVID-19 free. Our next COVID-19 testing will be February the 18th, right here in the same location at Mount Olivet Church from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. The pastor and the first lady, we get our test every single month. We want to make sure that we are safe to be around our members, that we are safe to be around our family members, to make sure that we are safe to be around our co-workers. And we invite you to do the same thing. Do just like the pastor and the first lady. Get your testing every single month to make sure that you know your health condition. But just be mindful that February the 18th will be the next COVID-19 testing. We're planning to do testing every single month until further notice. Amen. Also, we want to congratulate Sister Jordin Miller for being the week 4 winner of the MLK Tribute. We give the Lord praise. Amen. And we have a sensational gift card. Amen. That we're going to give to this wonderful young lady. Amen. That I believe is for Wendy's, if I'm not mistaken. It is for Chick-fil-A. Amen. Wonderful gift card that we've given to this young lady. And I was just saying to myself, Lord, I wish I was a youth so I could answer those questions so they get such wonderful prizes. Amen. But we want to congratulate Sister Jordin Miller for winning our week 4 MLK Tribute. Let's give her a hand. Amen. Outstanding job. And I am going to read the following announcements that comes from the YPD department. I just want to commend Sister Tracy Pelzer, who leads our YPD department. She is really working that ministry. And I'm so proud to say that she is my local president right here at Mount Olivet Church. Amen. The Super Bowl of Caring. Super Bowl of Caring. This announcement says that the youth of Mount Olivet Church challenge you to help them reach their goal. The YPD will collect cups of noodle soup to help feed the less fortunate families. Our goal is to donate 100 cups of noodle soup to a shelter on February the 7th, 2021. Please drop off your soup donations to help make our mission possible. And these are the soups here. The cups of soups here that we want you to go out and purchase so that we can donate those to charity. The scripture reading says, "For if the willingness is there, the gift is accepted according to what one has, not according to what one does not have." And that is 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 12. Reading the next announcement, this is a moment in history. Our young people are really working here at Mount Olive Amy Church. It says, "Greetings, parents and children. Mount Olive Amy Church youth will be exhibiting a moment in Black History Museum. All school age and above youth will be given a famous African American icon. Each youth will be responsible for the research of their assigned person. Please prepare yourselves to dress up as your icon and give it 2 to 3 minutes of details about your person. Examples such as your birth, the birth date, the education, and parents, and etc. We encourage you to use props to help identify your persons." All right. We look forward to seeing your exhibit on Sunday, February the 21st at 10:40 a.m. So let us encourage our youth to participate in our wonderful moment in history. Remember, next month is Black History Month, and we want to do our part to show that we are proud and pleased of how the Lord has brought us from a mighty long way. Going on with the announcements, I'm getting very close to finishing. Amen. Tax statements are in the mail right now per our church secretary, Sister Chastity Hardy. They are being mailed. Let us be mindful that we are in a COVID-19 stage right now. We do not encourage you to come and try to receive any tax statements in person. In fact, we're not going to give them in person. We're putting them in the mailbox for not only our safety, but for your safety. So look for your tax statements in the mail. Amen. Let us continue to lift our sick and shut-in members in prayer all over the church. We continue to pray for Sister Lula Hilliard. We will continue to pray for Brother Walter Brown, who was in the hospital. Amen. We continue to pray for Sister Evelyn Oliver and family. We pray for Brother Marvin Wright. And we continue to pray for Sister Dale Brown. Let us continue to pray for our sick and shut-in members all over the church. And let us continue to pray for those who are going through their hour of bereavement. Thank you for praying for this pastor, who has been going to funerals for my very own family. We funeralized my cousin, the elder Lord Grace Haynes, not only 2 weeks ago, and then this past week, we funeralized my cousin at Emmanuel Amy Church, Raymond, Washington. So we want to continue to thank you for praying for the Simpson family, that the Lord will strengthen us during our time of bereavement. And I just want to commend our trustees and those who came out here yesterday. The pastor has very observant eyes. When I stepped on the grounds this morning, I saw the building of the church looking exceptionally clean. Thank you so much for pressure washing the church. Amen. For this is none other than the house of God. And we should take care of God's house just like we take care of our very own. So I thank the men of Mount Olive Amy Church, the trustees, for coming out on Saturday and pressure washing our church. It may seem like a small thing to some people, but it is a big thing for the pastor. Amen. And now we get to our offertory moment. Amen. And this is what I want you to do. This is Missionary Sunday. Amen. We want to support our missionaries. The pastor has put in his envelope $10. To give to the Missionary Society. And every single missionary is supposed to be giving dues on the fifth Sunday of every month. Amen. So let us continue to support our WMS ministry. Also, let's support our YPD ministry. Let us also support our lay organization ministry. Let's support all the ministries of the church. So the pastor is leading the way. I'm giving my $10. To the WMS Society on top of my tithes and my offering, amen, so that they can do ministry from their location, amen. So this is what I want you to do. If you are going to give your tithes and offering by way of your electronic device, by Unify, hold up your electronic device in the air. If you are going to bring your tithes and offerings by the church, Raise your envelopes in the air. Hallelujah. I'm one of those bold soldiers. Amen. Raise your wallets. Raise your pocketbooks. Because the Lord has great delight in blessing his people. Raise your offerings up in the air. And the Lord is looking at your offering and he is smiling on your face. The Lord, he is looking at your wallet. He is looking at your checkbooks. He is looking at everything that pertains to your finances. And the Lord is going to multiply what you have. And your faith has to believe that he will. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, look upon the hand of God that is raised in faith. With the offerings in their hands. Lord, I pray, God, that that hand that is raised, oh Lord, bless the health of that person with the raised hand, oh Father God. And if they stand in need of anything else in their lives, oh God, bless them right where they are. And Lord, as you bless their health, oh God, as you regulate their vital signs, look at the offering that is in their hands. I pray, God, that you will bless that offering. And I pray, God, that you will multiply the offering that it might be used for the upkeep and the building of your kingdom. For it's in the name of Jesus the Christ we pray. The saints of God said, amen. Amen. Thank you for being so obedient unto the Lord that you will raise your offerings. And you would give it in advance. Amen. You give it in advance from your heart and receive it as you bring it. Amen. So now we are getting into our wonderful worship service. We have upgraded our worship service so that it would have more robust flavor so that you would enjoy worshiping with us every single Sunday morning. So this morning we have a youth that has come to do a praise dance. And we have a special person that's going to give us a selection before we hear the message. Amen. So I'm going to make all that announcement and I'm going to get out of the way. The worship service is going to continue to run. First, we're going to have a sensational praise dance by our winner, amen, of our MLKMK trivia, Sister Jordin Miller. Amen. And then after her praise dance, your first lady, yes, your beautiful first lady, she's going to come and sing us in the Holy Spirit to receive the worshiping word of the Lord. So your first lady, Sister Lashele, Yvette Simpson, will come after our praise dance to give us a selection. And then after the selection of your wonderful first lady, we're going to hear from our WMS president, amen, Sister Bernice Howell, who will give us a missionary word on this Missionary Sunday. And then once that is all over, we're going to extend the right hand of fellowship and pray and close our worship. Let us give the Lord some praise.
Here I stand, here I stand, for
Amen.
His holy name. He's forgiven us another chance to call and serve and pray and serve you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you. There's none like you, none like you. You got all the power. You can do all things but faith. Oh, Lord, just have mercy upon us, Jesus. Have mercy upon us. Lord, as I come before you this hour in the morning, just go with me, Jesus. You give me the word to say. Just use me. Take me out of self. Let me say what thus saith the Lord. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, Jesus. And it is well in my soul. I'll be reading from John, Gospel of John, the first chapter, starting at the first verse. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. That means Jesus. All things came into being through him, and apart from him, nothing came into being that has come into being. In him was life, and the light was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There came a man from God, whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify about that life, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but he came to testify about the light. There was the true light which cometh into the world and to enlighten every man. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and those who were his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, even to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, not of the will of the flesh, not of the will of God, but will of man, but of God. Thank you. My subject is Jesus is the light. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Can you imagine this world was just void? She said, in the beginning, God created, God prepared, formed, and created the heaven and the earth. In this world, there was nothing, but the Word was heaven. Because God is the Word. He said, the earth was without form and an empty waste, and darkness was upon the face of the great, very great deep. The Spirit of the Lord of God was moving over the face of the earth. And God said, let there be light. There was light. And God saw that the light was good, and he approved it. And God separated the light from the darkness. And God called the light day and the darkness night. All God had to do was speak the word. That's why he wanted us to speak the word. Christ was in the beginning with God because both are one and is eternal. All things were made by God, and without him was not anything made. God made everything. God made the world by a word. And he was the word. He made the earth full of his goodness, but yet it's empty of his praise. We don't praise God enough. We got to praise God. We got to give him glory. He deserves it because we are nothing without him. In him is life, and the life was the light of all men. God gives light to all mankind, everywhere. He gives all us the light. see ourselves as we really are. Sinners in need of a Savior. We all need a Savior. To follow that life, we need to repent. You want Jesus' life? Repent. Ask God to forgive me for your sin. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. When we let our light shine in the darkness, darkness don't have no power to force itself back into our life because of the light. Darkness only comes, only have power when you give into it. The Bible said, what is darkness? Darkness is evil, sin, lying, cheating, anything that prevents you from serving God. Please, if you are in darkness, get the light, receive the light. Jesus is that light, and he's waiting on you. He's waiting on all of us to change. There came a man sent from God who named him John. He was God's messenger. God gave John a mission and a message. John came as a witness to testify about him, about that life, so that all men might believe through him. All men. John was not the light, but came to testify about that life. John was, Jesus sent John to prepare the people for Jesus' coming, preaching repentance. There was the true light that cometh into the world to enlighten everybody. Jesus is coming to help us see our way to God. He was in the world, and the world did not know him. Even the people that were chosen by him to prepare the world for the Messiah rejected him. And that was in the Old Testament in Isaiah. Jesus took our nature upon himself and dwelt among us. He came to his own, and they did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave them to the right become children of God. Children of God were and is born again Christian who believe in the name of Jesus. Receiving new life from God, you've got to be born again. Repent and let Jesus make changes in your life, inside and out. The light, the word, the light became flesh, meaning becoming human. Christ became the perfect teacher, the perfect example, as a model of what we are to become. He was perfect. He made you, he made me. He showed us how to live and give us the power to live that way. Don't you want that power? The word, most powerful thing, the word is the most powerful thing in the world, universe. That's the word. Because when you got the word, you got Jesus.
Amen.
And Jesus is the word. The psalm said, the Lord is my life, life and salvation. Whom shall I fear? If God is your life and salvation, you don't have anything to fear because God didn't give us the spirit of faith. Mm-hmm. Believe it. Yeah. God said it. His word is true. The gospel is life. Yeah. The light is sweet and rejoices the heart. Those that hate the light want to live in darkness because of their lifestyle. They are living. They make excuses for their evil deeds. They do not like to hear the truth. People don't want to hear the truth no more. You tell them about their sin, they don't pay you any attention. But God's word is true. And my mom always said, the truth will set you free. All evil that you do as a sinner in this world, you have to give account of it in the judgment. All the sin, all evil that you did, all that you didn't treat even up. You got to give a comment. The song says, walk in the light, that beautiful light. Are you walking in the light? Are you serving and trusting God in your life? The world is full of people, but God sits high and he looks down on us. If you are living in darkness, come out, repent, open your heart and let the light come in, that beautiful light. Accept him as your personal Savior. Lord, let no one distract you from serving God. Peace and favor rest on you when you serve God. You know, God is a good God. God is good. And all he wants to do is to serve him in truth and in the spirit. If you say that you love your brother and hate God, say you love God and hate your brother, you are not telling the truth. Because God is a God of love. How can you love God if Missionary, you never see him? And there's your brother, you see him every day. God said he is love. You don't love your brother. God is not in you. That's why we should love our brother. Love. Because the last word he said, love. He leave us love. Love for all fellow men. Love that passes all understanding. God is a God of all. Yeah. He's not for me and he's not for you. But he is for all of us. He sits high and he looks low at all that's going on in this world. And you think God is satisfied? No. There's so much ahead. So much of shooting, so much of killing. God is not satisfied with what we are doing in this world. That's why we got to repent. Repent of our sin. Get closer to God. Let him use us. Tell others about the word of God. Tell them that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Oh, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Have mercy. God, give us mercy. And he give us grace. We should accept what God gives. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Accept him. Love him like he loves us. Because there is no greater love than God. No greater love. Now, he's good. He's good. He's good. He's good. God is our all in all, and he's our everything. This is the life. Jesus is the light of the world. He is the light. Look at me. I'm not talking the light in the church or the light in the home, but he's that glowing light. He has everything. Everything. He has everything that we need. Everything that we need, all we got to do is ask for. He says, it's your asking, he'll give it. That's what we got to do. Ask. Ask God. Ask God to forgive us. Ask God to clean us up. Parents, we should teach our children about parents. Because Christ is real. If you can't teach your children if you don't know yourself. Amen. You got to know Christ for yourself to teach your children. If you don't know him, fine. He's not all the time. God is good. God is good. That's why so many of our children are dying young. Because they do not want to listen. They don't want to listen to no one. And we got a Christian, we got to get out and bring them in, the lost. That's why Christ said, you can be in the church, but you got to go out on the highways and the sideways and dive in. Tell them about Jesus. Tell them about his goodness. Oh, just tell them. Tell them whether they want to hear it or not. Tell them. Because God is real. God is the light of my salvation. boys, Jonathan and Justin. We would get in one other room. And we would get to praying, reading scripture. And we would start praying. And I know it was going, because the Holy Ghost would come in and the house would light up like fire. And I know it was going.
Yeah.
I know it was going. And I thank God for it. I thank God for using me for it to teach them. Because my praying and my singing, it's not even. Because look where they are now. You know God is good. God is good. The word. The word can last forever. I don't have nothing too much to say. But this is, as I said, we as parents, we are missionaries. Do missionary work. Do missionary work. Not only in the church, but out. Out. Visit the sick. If you can't visit them, call them. Check on them. Because we all are one. One in Christ. That's why he said, love ye one another. We should have the love for all. Not some. For all. Not only people in the church. Not for the one that hates you, but love for all. Because Jesus loved all of us. All of us. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Lord, I thank you. Let the word of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be accepted by you, my soul, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
No!
Let us give the Lord some praise. All over the house of God. And even though you're not in Mount Olive AME Church, the Lord has extended his altar to your home. And the house of God is right there in your home. So give the Lord praise right where you are. For Jesus is the light of this world. And I am smiling from ear to ear. Amen. Did not our WMS president speak the word of God with grace and wisdom? Amen. Thank you so much, Sister Bernice Howell, for bringing the word of God this morning on this WMS Sunday. This young lady is the proud mother of two twins. Praise the Lord. Brother Joshua Howell and Brother Jonathan Howell. Amen. One of the twins is pastoring right now, and I can see where he gets his preaching spirit from. They were reared up and raised up in the presence of the Holy Spirit through his Whitmer family. And so I'm so proud to say that I am the pastor of Sister Bernice Howell. And I'm so proud to say that I am the pastor of Brother Jonathan Howell, who is pastoring over there at Spring Hill AME Church in the Manning District. Amen. And his brother is with us, and we know that the Lord is working with him. Amen. So we give the Lord praise. Amen. Before we extend the right hand of fellowship, Sister Bernice Howell, this beautiful polka dot paint bag, praise the Lord, is all for you. And the advisor of the WMS has taken the time out to be a blessing to you. And so as we stay in line with the CDC protocol so that we do not come in contact with one another, we will present this wonderful gift to you for accepting the opportunity to speak on behalf of the WMS. And the First Lady will gladly make sure that you receive this wonderful gift. Let's give the Lord some praise. Amen. Now as I was taking in the message, the Lord is speaking. I was always taught that when the preaching is going forth, you should have a pen and a pad. So when you hear God speaking, you should write down what you hear God saying. And while I was listening to the word of God going forth, I heard the Lord say that his light, God's light, is not like the light provided by man. See, man can cut their light on and off when they feel like it. If you don't pay your light bill, guess what? They're going to cut your light off and you don't have the ability to look at TV or even have light in your house. I am so glad that God's light is not like the light of man. But God's light is always lit all the time, not only for those who follow him and serve him, but his light is on for all who will receive them, whether we receive them or not. And his light is on because he desired that all should know him and be saved. So now we're at the moment of decision. If you want the light of God in your life, all you do is have to accept Jesus, the Christ, as your Lord and your Savior. Charles Spurgeon, a great orator and theologian, said that Jesus, he became what we are just so that we might become what he is. And so when we accept Christ as our Lord and Savior, he automatically gives you his spirit that you will become what he is. So if you've never accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior on this live stream, you can do it right now. If the Lord has allowed you to live 31 days in the first month of the brand new year, you need to tell the Lord thank you. Why let this minute pass you by and not accept Christ as your Savior? If you were to die the very next minute, where will your soul reside? I tell you right now, if you don't have Christ as your Lord and Savior, you will not reside in the kingdom of God. But we extend the right hand of fellowship unto you. And we want you to accept Christ as your Lord and Savior. And I promise you, my brother, and I promise you, my sister, you will never regret accepting Christ into your life. Well, maybe there's someone right now that is sick on this live stream. And let me tell you something. There's power in the light of the Lord that will heal the sick, cure cancer, and regulate vital signs, lower sugar, diabetes, and high blood pressure. The Lord, He is able to heal you from all your sickness. If your faith will allow you to believe that God is able, whatever you stand in need of this morning, we offer Christ to you. Let us pray. Lord, we say thank you for extending your light of love to all of us. You loved us so much, you sent your only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life, a life filled with light and love and power. Thank you for saving that one right now that is on this live stream who has never confessed Christ as Lord and Savior. Thank you for saving another soul that was in the hands of Satan. You snatched them away, oh God, and you placed them on the right path, oh God, a right path of victory on to a place, oh God, where there's no more sickness, no more dying, and no more crying. And Lord, right now, that person right now who is racking in pain on their sick bed, we claim healing right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you for healing that person right where they are. We thank you for healing that person in their home. We thank you for healing that person who's staying in the Methodist home. We thank you for going by the hospital, oh God, and healing that person that is bedbound in the sick bed in the hospital. Lord, we thank you for healing people who are sick on their jobs, oh God, and they can't stay away from work, but they got to work because, Lord, they have to make their ends meet, and they're working while they're sick. Lord, we thank you for healing everyone right where they are. And Lord, right now, those who have fallen asleep right now in you, oh God, we pray, God, that you will continue, Lord, to wipe the tears, oh Lord, of those who are crying because they've lost a loved one. But Lord, we know, oh God, that your kingdom is open, oh Father God, for those who live for you, and they are living with you right now in your kingdom. Keep the families, oh God, in your care, and watch over them day and night. We receive your blessings that you've showered upon us. For it's in the name of Jesus the Christ we all pray. And the saints of God said, amen. Have a victorious week, my honor baby church, and to each and every one of you that has joined us for our live stream. God bless you, and I love you, and there's nothing that you can do about it. God bless you.
The master of the sea.
Thank you for watching. I pray that this service has been a blessing to you. Please join us on next Sunday at 11 a.m. God bless you.